Coming up, we take a look at a new way of how you can harness the power of cloud authentication while still keeping your passwords on-premises using Azure Active Directory, pass-through authentication, and seamless single sign-on capabilities. We'll show you how Azure AD can now validate securely your passwords against on-premises Active Directory, all without the need for expensive on-premises infrastructure, and automatically sign your users in while they're at work. Joined today by Swaroop from the Azure Active Directory team. Welcome.
Thanks for having me on the show.
So let's start with pass-through authentication. So is it fair to think of this as an authentication bridge?
Yes, that's fair. But the big thing here is with the release of this bridge, any company, small or large, can now adopt cloud authentication.
So that's a pretty bold statement, but what do you actually mean by that?
Sure. The control plane for security and access control is moving from the network layer to identity. That's why more and more of you are using Azure AD, not just for user sign-in, but for other things such as password management in the cloud, group-based assignments to applications, publishing on-premises applications to the cloud, conditional access policies, and so on. Now, with password authentication, you get all of that, but you get to keep your passwords on-premises. They don't need to leave your internal organizational boundary. It requires zero management and is free to use.
So it's easy to use, it's secure, scalable authentication, but can you show us what the experience actually looks like?
Sure, I can do that. So here I am on the standard Office 365 sign-in screen. I'm going to sign in using the same credentials that I used to sign into on-premises applications. And I'm in. Although this looks like a straightforward sign-in experience, what's happened is behind the scenes, password authentication has successfully validated my password against my on-premises Active Directory in real time. So let me show you how this experience gets even better, this time by combining password authentication with a new seamless single sign-on capability.
Okay.
Here I'm signed into my domain join machine, and I'm going to try to access my on-premises and cloud applications using the application access panel.
Okay.
When I get to the Azure AD sign-in page, notice that I don't have to enter my username or my password to sign in. I just get in.
Wow, so you didn't have to enter your username, password, you were just in. How did all of that work? Did you have to do anything special there?
Well, we had to do a few things to set it up, but Azure AD now talks Kerberos. That's the big thing.
Great. So I imagine it's also pretty important for a lot of organizations watching that are concerned about security and compliance and maybe not able to synchronize their passwords to the cloud. And it's also great that as a user, you don't have to remember two sets of passwords to maybe access your on-premises network and cloud applications. But how does this all differ then for people that use Azure AD today?
Well, Azure AD always had a wide range of authentication options. Some of you use directory synchronization to sync just usernames from on-premises Active Directory to the cloud, but that means you have to manage separate passwords in the cloud. We also have password hash sync, which lets you securely sync password hashes from on-premises to the cloud. That works really well for many of you. In both these cases, authentication happens in the cloud. If you wanted authentication to happen on-premises, your primary option was to use federation with ADFS. But this needs additional infrastructure and network configuration on-prem. It works great if you're trying to support other diverse forms of authentication beyond passwords, such as smart cards and third-party multi-factor authentication providers. Having said that, if you want to manage passwords on-premises without implementation complexity, then password authentication is the best option for you. It gives you the full power of Azure AD Cloud Authentication and its full feature set, and lets you do it in a low-cost, secure, and scalable way without the need for any additional on-premises hardware. So let me show you how password authentication works. We start by installing a lightweight on-premises agent on the same server as Azure AD Connect. We recommend that you install additional agents on other servers to get high availability of sign-in requests. Yeah. You can install these agents on domain controllers too, for example. Now, these agents require zero management and will auto-update. When the user enters their username and password on the Azure AD sign-in page, our service actually encrypts the password using a public key and then places the username and encrypted password on a queue for validation. One of your agents on-prem makes an outbound call from your network to retrieve the username and encrypted password.
So that must mean then it's using kind of a listening mechanism for outbound HTTPS calls over port 443, that means there's no inbound calls then coming through the firewall?
Yes, that's right. So actually what happens next is the agent decrypts the password using a private key that only it has access to and tries to validate it against the on-premises Active Directory. Now, the result of this, which is returned by the domain controller, success or failure, is returned back to the agent, which then forwards it up to Azure AD. Azure AD then decides, you know, what to do with it. If a multi-factor authentication is enabled, the user is challenged for it. If not, the user has just signed into the application.
So you really are then building a bridge, basically, that goes between your on-premises infrastructure and the cloud. And as you showed, the experience gets even better using seamless single sign-on. But how did that work?
So let's take the use case of a user on a domain joined machine inside the corporate network trying to access a cloud application. During setup, Azure AD Connect creates a computer account representing Azure AD inside your on-premises Active Directory. Now, when the user visits the Azure AD sign-in page, we use JavaScript to request for a Kerberos ticket for the computer account. Now, this user's machine having line of sight to the domain controller lets it acquire the Kerberos ticket. Now, the ticket includes the identity of the user and is then forwarded up to Azure AD. Azure AD reviews that ticket and decides what to do with it, and if everything looks good, signs the user in silently. No password required, and you didn't need to do Azure AD join. This works on Windows 7, Windows 8 devices, even Macs, and across all major browsers. So let me show you how the setup experience works. Here I'm running Azure AD Connect. When I run the wizard, I should make sure to choose the custom installation path instead of express settings. Mm-hmm. At this point, we end up installing a few of our required components for sync, and we'll get to the user sign-in page in a second. When you get to the user sign-in page, you need to choose password authentication and check this box to enable seamless single sign-on.
Okay.
Of course, I still need to finish all my directory synchronization steps as before.
So this will be familiar if you've run this tool before.
Right, that's right. For example, in this case, I'm connecting up to the woodgrove.online Active Directory using my enterprise domain credentials to actually start the sync configuration process.
Okay.
Then I figure out, you know, how do users sign into Azure AD by choosing the UPN. Mm-hmm. And then I figure out what kind of domains and OUs I want to sync. And right. basically just select the default settings for other options.
Okay.
However, when I get to the optional features page, I need to make sure that the password synchronization is disabled because you don't want password hashes flowing into the cloud.
Makes sense.
Now, it is at this stage that Azure AD Connect uses my domain admin credentials to actually create that computer account representing Azure AD that I talked about when we were talking about seamless single sign-on. And finally, at the end of the wizard, this is when we get ready to install the password authentication agent, enable the two features on the tenant, and also configure all of the sync that is required to make this work end-to-end.
Okay, so it's just about completed there, it looks like. So those are all Azure AD Connect settings. Anything that I need to do then on my endpoint outside of the kind of these server-side settings?
Yeah, that's a great question. So to allow Azure AD to actually receive Kerberos tickets, what you need to do is you need to use group policy to push two new Azure AD URLs to your user's internet zone settings.
Okay.
So here I'm actually using my group policy management editor, and I'm trying to set up the site to zone assignment list and enabling that policy. As part of enabling that policy, you see that I've entered these two new Azure AD login URLs. These are the same URLs for every customer. And the value one there represents the internet zone.
All right, so now all this is running as a service. Is there anything that I need to do in terms of monitoring this in the Azure portal?
Yeah, so to verify that everything looks good, you can actually go into the Azure portal, click on the Azure AD Connect plate, and check that the two features are showing up as enabled. You can click on the password authentication link here to check the status of the agent that we just installed.
Great, so this seems really straightforward, but is there anything else I need to know about with the solution?
As I said before, installing additional agents gives you high availability out of the box, right? All on-premises Active Directory actions, such as disabling users, setting user logon hours, for example, for retail workers, are immediately enforced. We also protect your on-premises Active Directory accounts by filtering out brute force password attacks in the cloud. This is a feature that's on by default for all customers.
So really having Azure AD as the control plane with password management, conditional access, auditing, identity protection, all this is really powerful, keeping passwords on premises, but what's the team working on next?
Yeah, so looking ahead, we want to make it even easier to deploy password authentication. So things like setting it up from the Azure portal instead of Azure AD Connect, and also providing admins rich sign-in reports and health information about the agents on-prem.
So really great new technology, great overview, Swaroop. Where can people then go to learn more if they want to set this up on their sites?
Right, so password authentication and seamless single sign-on are both free features. They're now generally available to all Azure AD customers, including all Office 365 customers. You can learn more by visiting the links below.
Thanks for joining us today on the show, and don't forget to keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates across Microsoft. All the time we have for this show, goodbye for now.